Hi everyone, this is John Dickinson from motionworks.net, back with a Sapphire tip for you. This time we're going to be talking about Sapphire and how it works with type. And as far as I'm concerned, type loves Sapphire. And there are plenty of ways that you can use Sapphire to make your type stand out. So let's take a look at how, in this example, you can use Sapphire Grunge with type to create a vibrant look really fast. Then we'll combine that look with other Sapphire effects to take it to the next level. So I've got my text selected. I'm going to apply Sapphire Grunge by typing in S Grunge, double click. And first thing I want to do is load a preset by clicking on Load Preset. I'm going to choose this one over here, Fluoro Splotches, and double click. And that fills my frame up with these splotches. So in order to have it fill the layer only, for Matte from Layer, I'm going to choose Grunge. But you can see it's still covering the edges of the text, so we can't actually read that text. So one more thing I have to do is come down to the bottom of the effect and just check this option here, Crop Grunge to Matte. So now we can see it. And if I just toggle the transparency grid, you can see we're seeing the grunge on top of the text and there's no transparency. We can change that by changing the Combine option to Grunge only. And now we can see the transparency. Okay, so now I'm going to duplicate the grunge layer. I'm going to drop that one behind. Just turn this one off for now. And for this one, I'm going to uncheck Crop Grunge to Matte. And I'm going to make the stamp size smaller. Maybe something like that. I'll just turn this one back on now. Okay, so now we can see the splotches going beyond the edges of the text, which makes this look a little bit more natural and less CG. Now, at the moment, the duplicate's using the same random seed as the original. So I'm going to select the duplicate, and to find the seed quickly, I'm just going to type in seed, and just going to change that to something that I like. Maybe something like that. I like that big green splotch there. And at the moment, we have no animation whatsoever. So I'm just going to search for my shake parameters, and I'm going to increase the shake amplitude. Just press the spacebar to preview that. Now you can see that all of the stamps are moving in unison. If you want to move the stamps individually, you can change the setting here, per stamp amplitude. If I just increase that, you can see the stamps get their own individual shake. Okay, so now we want to give a little bit of movement to the grunge on the layer above. This time I'm going to use the random seed. And I'm going to make a quick expression just by holding down Alt or Option on Mac, clicking the stopwatch and typing in time. And if we preview that, you can see the seeds changing on every frame. So we're getting this really interesting animation. Let's try something a little bit different. I'm going to just type in blur in the search dialog here, and I'm going to blur that grunge. You may like a little or a lot. I'm going to give it a fair bit here. And you can see that in itself is quite a good look. It's a little bit easier to read the text there. I want to just show the edges of the text though. So I'm going to use Edge Detect. Sapphire Edge Detect. And that's going to show me the edges. And I'm going to change Effect from RGB Edges to Chroma Edges. And see what this does. You get these really nice, colorful edges. Next, I'm going to apply Sapphire Glow. And I'm going to decrease the threshold and increase the brightness till we can see a nice glowing effect there. Maybe a little bit brighter. Just adjust the glow width slightly. That looks a bit better. And for Matte from Layer, I'm going to choose the Grunge 2 layer. And importantly, over here in the Source dropdown, I'm going to choose Effects and Masks so that Sapphire Glow can recognize that there are effects applied to the other grunge layer. And that's looking really nice. So you can see Sapphire Grunge can look really good with text either by itself or combined with other Sapphire effects. And keep in mind here, we haven't used any keyframes. Thanks for watching, and be sure to click on the link in the description to download a free trial of Sapphire for After Effects and check out these great plugins for yourself. Also follow Boris Effects on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter to stay up to date with the latest information and training materials on Continuum, Sapphire, Mocha Pro, and all of the Boris Effects products.